Hello. The US Secretary of State John Kerry has phoned the Israeli and Palestinian leaders to urge calm after weeks of shootings and stabbings that have left more than 40 dead. On Friday, Israeli forces killed four Palestinians, including a man disguised as a news photographer who was shot after stabbing an Israeli soldier. Our Middle East editor Jeremy Bowen has more.
Jerusalem, city of beauty, sanctity and hate. Its holy places are at the center of the conflict. Only Muslims can pray in the compound around the Golden Dome of the Rock at the Aqsa Mosque. The Israelis deny they want Jews who venerate the site to worship there too. Palestinians don't believe them. That's a major reason for the anger on the streets across the Palestinian territories. This was Bethlehem, just outside Jerusalem. Israel says Palestinian leaders tell lies to incite riots and the killing of Jews. Palestinians say they don't need to be told when to be angry. After almost 50 years of an occupation that is always coercive and often brutal. The alleyways of Jerusalem's old city are full of tension and fear. Israel has reinforced security to stop any more attacks on Jews. This was the spot where an Israeli man was killed and his wife and child wounded.
We're talking about a small number within the Israeli Arab population that unfortunately are both listening to the incitement that is being put out on the internet as well as by different organizations.
But then we saw a Palestinian youth who was angry about his mother being questioned. He thought too aggressively. Palestinians get constant reminders that Israel is in charge. It can mean a lifetime of humiliations.
But you tell me, do you think people get provoked here?
It's normal.
For some, that produces a murderous rage. In an ultra-religious district of Jerusalem, death notices have been posted for Yeshayahu Krishevsky. He was killed last Tuesday when a Palestinian rammed his car into a bus queue. Thousands came to mourn a respected rabbi. The rabbi's son says Palestinians targeted Jews long before Israel captured and occupied East Jerusalem in 1967.
It happened because the terrorist searched for a Jew. That's what he searched for. They're not doing this because of occupation and also not because of Al-Aqsa. But the solution is to somehow get along together.
The rabbi's killer, who was shot dead, came from Jabal Mukaba in occupied East Jerusalem. He was Ala Abu Jamal, who snapped ground down by the occupation, according to his cousin, Muawiyah.
Was there.
He wants peace, even though his house has just been destroyed in an Israeli reprisal against his brother, who killed five Israelis last year.
Maybe in the 20 years, when my son will come 20 years old, maybe he'll think about killing. Because he see this site, they destroy his house. Why they must live this situation? The children, me, my wife, my father, everyone, the Jewish, why they must live this situation?
In all the years of conflict between the Israelis and the Palestinians, this kind of thing has happened so many times. Killing, destruction, reprisals, counter-reprisals, more killing, more destruction. That's how new generations get entrapped in the hatred. And so far, no leader, no diplomat has been able to cut through it all to make peace. Hassan Mahania, aged 15, was shot dead after he stabbed two young Israelis and attacked the police. His father, Khaled, can't understand where, as a parent, he went wrong.
I don't know, really, I don't know.
Grief cuts across this divided city. Palestinians and Israelis share tears and anger and not much else. As it stands, that won't change. Jeremy Bowen, BBC News, Jerusalem.